Hey guys, what's up? It's Carl here, back with another episode in the new studio and still getting very, very used to things. This episode, though, is all around setups in this new loft vibe office space. It's actually what's going on behind the camera, behind you guys. I've got a bit more of my furniture set up. I've hauled in some of the heavier pieces like the TV, and we are slowly making this place a fully working studio. Let's swap spots and we'll take a look. So this space behind me, I've been absolutely dying for a spot where I can interchange my TV setups. Those are some of my most popular vids and they're some of the most fun for me to make. Naturally, this is that new spot. And in there right now, we've got one of the setups that I've been dying to create. It's almost a bit dated now because, say, the TV, it's a 65-inch OLED. It is from 2019. I got it at the end of last year, but naturally the studio renos have taken so long. So this is it. It's the C965 from LG. Since it's an OLED, it is the top of the line series, but it has now come down in price in 2020. And I know that you can snag these for 20, 30. I've even seen deals around that 40% off from MSRP, which is super dope. Take full advantage. I'll try to leave the best deals listed down below. And because it's an OLED, it has all the benefits of super high contrast ratios and nice and deep blacks. The main reason why I wanted an OLED panel for this studio or this office was because of all the natural light that we get. And I have a ton of reflection. It's something that I've learned from my own studio, my living room, my place where I live right now, that suffers a lot from glare. And when you look off to the side this way, we're getting a ton of natural light streaming through. I'm probably half overexposed. I need to figure out the lighting situation here. Normal TV setups, you'd be struggling with glare issues. So if you do have a ton of natural light, if you've got a lot of windows in your place, consider an OLED. But the next piece of the setup, which I'm actually more excited to talk about because it's the newer piece, is the soundbar. It's the SN11RG, and I was first introduced to this back at CES of this year, and I am typically a fan of OEM hardware. It pairs well together, it works right out of the box, it's usually plug and play, so setups are quite painless and simple. Because I knew I had this OLED already waiting for me, this was the soundbar that I was looking to pair with it. It is the top of the line of their audio products paired with TV, so it is a bit pricier, but it does come with some additional hardware new to 2020, and that first being wireless surround sound. And surround sound typically isn't an option you get with a plug and play soundbar. It usually involves extra cables, a lot of extra planning because no one likes cables running throughout your house. But you can see right here, completely wireless. Of course, we need to connect it to power. They do typically live on either side of your couch. That's something that this setup is lacking, hence why I'm sitting in a office or computer chair. But these do live on either side of wherever your setup happens to be. They do pair wirelessly, and that is the same thing for the wireless subwoofer, which you also see off to the side right there. The soundbar itself meets Dolby Vision, Dolby Atmos, and DTS:X, so if you do have high-res content, you can take full advantage. You've got 11 50-watt speakers facing pretty much every direction. You've got full 24-bit high-res audio. Bluetooth Wi-Fi connection plugs straight into the TV via one optical cable. Within 30 seconds, you have it fully paired. Right out of the box, I don't think you can get too much better than that for a plug-and-play soundbar. And maybe my only criticism, maybe this is a bit of a design cue flaw, because it is paired with this specific OLED, the C9, it does sit a bit high. It doesn't have extra legs or isn't overly thick, so maybe that is a fault of the TV for being so thin and low profiled. I do notice in a lot of ads or LG's promo material, they typically have the OLED mounted to the wall. Everything doesn't have wires. It looks too good to be true, but keep that in mind if you do have them paired like this. Doesn't impact performance at all, and you can still see 98% of what's going on in the TV. Probably gonna end up wall mounting this at some point in the future. I don't think I've missed anything else from the soundbar. The design is super minimal, it's simple, it's got the same gunmetal finish as the OLED. I think they do pair perfectly. It does have Google Assistant built in, so you can control the rest of your smart home tech or your TV setup with the soundbar. And as for the rest of the setup, just like my TV and soundbar pairing, I've kept things super, super minimal. all. Probably the only tech accessory that I have is the Xbox One S in that limited edition, or I guess custom colored orange. I did get that from Colorware. It does live on my orange wall, which you saw at the beginning of this video. I use that to watch Netflix, to play games. I do also have a hint of Lego. My X-Wing fighter always have to have a bit of Lego in my sets. And I guess the furniture to wrap up this video, most of it is from a company called Rove Concepts. Everything is super white and minimal, just like the look of this entire loft slash new office space, so I think it ties in everything perfectly together. I'll leave everything linked, of course, down below. This has probably been my best soundbar setup that I've tested to date, and I'm looking forward to using it over the next couple months until, I guess, the next upgrades roll into the studio. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this very first look at the new office space with all the renos and all of the equipment in. Let me know how the video slash audio quality sounds. I'm not too sure until we go to post, but until then, I will catch the rest of you in one of my next vids or vlogs. Peace. And PS, if you guys are still tuned in, I love the LG soundbar and surround sound combo so much, I decided to get another one for here, my OG studio where I live, not the work studio. It was a simple plug and play via optical cable, and it was paired with a non-LG TV, and now I have surround sound in this living room setup. So now that officially concludes this episode. Peace.